गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। मैडम गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। ओके थैंक यू मैम। मैडम गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
இல்ல வேண்டாம் வேண்டாம் குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் டு யூ ஆல் கிரேஸ் மேம் ரோமனி சார் எல்லாம் குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் டு யூ ஆல்
थैंक यू मैम। குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் எவ்ரிவன் பிரசன்ட்
Good evening, one and all. Kindly mute all of you, your mic and video. People are still joining. Ma'am, shall we wait for another 10 minutes or we can start now?
Are you asking Selvi, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you myself? Yes, anyway.
No, you shall we wait for another 10 minutes, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. You like.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Because 56 members have joined. Yes, we can wait.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yeah. We'll wait for another 10 minutes, ma'am. Dear
sure,
participants,
ma'am.
Kindly patience yourself. Next 10 minutes, we can start our program. I think it's time to start our program. Good evening to one and all present here on the second day of 5D's National Level Faculty Development Program Training Series 1 held on 19th October to 23rd October 2020. Yesterday is the first day of this 5D's Faculty Development Program Training Series 1 and went on very well with our first special guest speaker, Dr. D. Venkatraman sir. He had given us a very elaborative speech on role of teacher in modern perspective. And also, he clearly clarified the doubts and questions raised from the participants' side at the end of the session. Participants are fully satisfied. Hence, the first day session has been completed. On continuation of the yesterday session, today is the second day. 20th October 2020 starts with today's special guest speaker, Dr. Mrs. Shelby S. Madam, Assistant Professor of Government College of Education Institution, Vellu. She is going to deliver a speech on traits of empowerment of self. Now, I'm handing to Mrs. Grace to introduce.
Good afternoon, one and all. Present here. I'm so privileged to welcome Dr. S. Selvi, who has her MA, MPhil, PhD, MBA in Education Management, and PG Diploma in CG as a qualification. She has 30 plus years of teaching experience and 16 plus years of research experience in her career as a Stoning Crown. In her dynamic career, she has served as Director for In-Service Training, MHRD, NSS Program Officer 2008-09, Question Paper Scrutiny Member, Kodaikanal University, Chief Examiner, Thiruvalluvar University, Examiner and Examiner for Practical Examination, BEd and MEd, TNTEU, Annamalai University, External Member in Passing Board Committee in Annamalai University, NKT College, External Examiner, IASC Saidapet, LWIASC Chennai, Annamalai University and Mother Teresa University. She was an Examiner, an Expert Committee in the Admission of Special BEd, NIPMED, Quad Member for various University Examinations, Board of Study Member and Academic Council Member for TNTEU and St. Ignatius College. Affiliation Inspector Committee Member, TNTEU. Member in Inspector Committee in Swachh Bharat. Member in NCTE Visiting Team. Additional Chief Superintendent for University Examination. Chief Superintendent and Camp Officer for University Examination Valuation. Chief Superintendent for University Examinations. She was a dynamic and efficient HOD, Department of English, AAA Government Arts College, Cheyyar, Principal in Divya College of Education, Chekpet, Principal FAG Government College for Education, Vellore. She has guided 50 plus scholars in MEd, MPhil and in PhD research. She still guides 3 scholars in PhD. She has received the Best Teacher Award from Tamil Nadu Educational Research Institute, Kalvi Deepam Award from ORC Vellore, Women Empowerment Award from Rotary Club, Vellore, Best Educationalist Award from International Institute of Education and Management, Delhi. She has received Lifetime Education Achievement Award from National International Compendium. She is an inspiring academic speaker, Master Trainer for English Language of College Teachers, and has organized several national level workshops, conferences, and seminars. She has authored several books in which 5 are ISBN to her credit. And to improve herself, she has attended several national and international seminars, symposiums, workshops, and trainings. She has presented at several state, national, and international podiums. She has an excellent experience in conducting interviews for recruiting lecturers and teachers for education colleges, matric, and higher secondary schools. She has been a dynamic resource person for many national and international webinars conducted by government and private colleges. I'm so honored, ma'am, to welcome you. I'm so privileged to welcome and introduce Dr. S. Selvi, Assistant Professor, Government College of Education Institution, Vellore, to take over this session as I mute myself to listen and to be enthralled by energetic, experience-filled knowledge. Unto us. Over to you, ma'am. Good day.
Thank you. Thank you, Grace Madam, for your good introduction about myself. Very pleasing manner you have given everything. Yes, good afternoon to everybody gathered here. First of all, I want to thank the principal, ma'am, Dr. Mrs. Gladys, the principal, Bharathi Women's College, Chennai, for having arranged this wonderful webinar program. I want to greet Dr. Mrs. Shyamla, HOD of Geography Department of Bharathi Women's College. Thank you very much, madam. And Dr. Mrs. Sujata for giving a good opportunity to take part in this online webinar program. I want to greet Dr. Venkatraman also because he is highly resourceful person. Much experience he has got. And he is also one of the part in this webinar program. And through him only I have got an opportunity. So I want to thank all the stakeholders of this program. The principal, HOD, and Sujata madam, and also the staff member, Grace. Everybody I want to thank. Yes, let me start my session. The topic given to me is Rights of Empowerment of Self. Let me present.
I
சர்டிபிகேட் போட மெக்கானிக்கும்
எஸ்
போகல இல்லையா லீகலுக்கு போகண்டானு நம்ம பண்ணிட்டு
இருக்கோம் அதுக்காக
அதுக்காக அப்போ முடிச்சிடுங்க அப்போ அதை எடுத்து போட்டு கிழக்கில போட்டு ஏன் பண்ணிட்டு
இருக்கீங்க எஸ் மேம் சுஜாதா மேம் ஆர் யூ ஏபிள் டு சீ மை ஸ்கிரீன்
புக் எடுத்துட்டு சர்வர் இல்லவனே அவனுக்கு கையில வச்சிட்டு தான் படம் ஓட்டேன் எல்லாம் ஒரு காப்பி எடுத்து
வச்சிட்டு எஸ் ஆர் யூ ஏபிள் டு சீ மை ஸ்கிரீன் Yeah, they are not going to give any trials of empowerment of self, but anyway I am not going to give any trials of self. Yeah, they are not going to give any trials of self, but anyway I am not going to give any trials of self. Yes, ma'am. 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 Yes, ma' the price of the teacher. That is why now I want to give not the traits of the traits means the qualities. I'm not going to give about the qualities of a teacher, because it is in general, as a teacher, as a professional, as an individual, what are the qualities we have to have? They are in common. We have already seen it yesterday, and also we know that we should be knowledgeable, skilled, talented, flexible, tolerable, convincing, and so on. There is a long list. And so now I'm going to give only the different skills. What are the skills we have to have? We have to develop. Because the theme of the webinar is innovation in teaching and learning. My topic is the traits of empowerment of self. So, dear participants, we all should empower ourselves by developing our knowledge, enriching the skills, and inculcating the values, which are very, very necessary for our profession and also for our life. And so, now let me ask one thing. What are you all? What will you be in the coming years? Most of us here attending the seminar, attending the webinar, maybe the teacher or professor. But anyway, how we are? Yes. What will be? What is our life? What is our wish? What do you want to become? We all will immediately give, I want to become a very successful professional. If I'm a teacher, I want to be a very successful, very excellent, very wonderful teacher, very wonderful professionals. There may be many students attending the program. Yes, you may take some profession in the coming years, next year or year after year you may take. You want to excel in your profession, in your career. For that, you need to develop certain things. What are the things? How can we make ourselves a wonderful teacher, excellent teacher, or a great person, a great professional? That's what we are going to see in this webinar. Yes, we all can get excellence in our profession by empowering ourselves. That is why the topic empowerment of self. We have to empower ourselves. How we have to empower ourselves? Before that, I have to give in brief the thing I'm going to give in this webinar. First thing is, what is empowerment? Because the topic is empowerment of self. And so I'm going to give what is empowerment, how can we empower ourselves, how will we be when we empower ourselves, how will the institution be where the employees are empowered? Yes. If the institution is filled up with the empowered employees, then we can find all the persons who are there are very enthusiastic. Empowered employees are very enthusiastic. whatever they do, full of enthusiasm they do. They are enthusiastic, they are positive, and they are very creative. The positive outlook they have got. Whatever the work given by the management, given by the HOD, or whatever the work they are undertaking for the sake of the student, they have got a positive outlook. And they are very creative because they have got empowered. They are empowered individual. So they do everything in a new manner, in an innovative manner. And they have increased self-confidence. Level of self-confidence is also very high. And they are key to develop their own skill. Yes, what are the skills I have already? What are the skills I have to develop according at present? At present, what is the skill? What are the skills is very much necessary for my career, for my profession, for the students that they know, they come to know, and they try to develop all this skill. And also, they find ways, not only developing the necessary skill, they try to find the ways how to make use of all these skills in this career. And loyalty and trust also they develop in the institution, towards the institution. And also they are feeling proud to be working in their organization. If they are working in a college, they feel proud of saying that I'm working in Bharati Women's College, I'm working in Government College of Education Vellore. Like that, they feel proud of working in their organization. And also they are very eager to contribute their institution's success. Yes, they try to contribute something or other for the sake of the improvement of the institution. They are able to understand and believe the vision of their organization. They generate ideas directly aimed at improving the services of their institution. Because of that, the result is increased productivity. When we talk about productivity in the institution, productivity refers to the second results. High percentage, rank holders, producing rank holders, and also placement of the students. If the individuals are working in some other area, some other field, some other department, there, according to that profession, according to that organization, there is much productivity because of the empowered individuals. And also quality of the institution, qualities of the company, qualities of the organization is also very great. Higher level of cooperation we can find among the individuals they are working in. Higher level of flexibility also we can find. And so there is much, because of the flexibility only, we can find much cooperation among the individual. So the individuals who are empowered are the real asset to the organization in which they are in, they are working at present, or in which they are going to be placed. How can we make ourselves empowered? Now we know we have to empower ourselves. We have to empowerment of self. And so we have to empower ourselves for the sake of ourselves and also for the sake of the institution in which we are working. Yes, how is it possible? By developing the knowledge, enrichment of skills, and inculcation of values. All these things are necessary. Usually, I used to say to my students, develop my education. Definition of education is development of knowledge, enrichment of skills, and inculcation of values. All these three things are necessary. And so we have to develop our knowledge, we have to enrich our skills, and also we have to inculcate values in our mind. Then only, by that only, we can develop, we can get empowerment. Yes. Now, yes, first of all, now I'm going to give many different skills. First of all, what we need is physical health. Yes, physical health. We all have to enrich ourselves regarding the knowledge, values, and skills. We all have to, we may already have knowledge and skills to some extent. That what we have already got should be enriched. My dear participants, now we are all under lockdown at our house. In our house we are not meeting together, but we don't know we don't have the usual kind of work as we did 6 months back, 6 or 8 months back. Surely we are getting up, doing whatever we do, and killing the time just by doing something that comes to our mind. Some may be complaining. Some may say that it is very boring, I could not pass the time. Don't think so. Lot of time we have in our hand. My dear participants, think of something useful, beneficial for you. Try to find out, try to find out your own interest. Some may be interested in cooking, some may be interested in tailoring, some may be interested in decorating houses, some may be interested in painting, or whatever it may be, the pleasure time activity, you have to analyze yourself. Find out in which area you have got interest. It may be related to studies, or some of the people, most of the participants are teachers, professors, and so you can involve in writing articles. You can contribute, you can write some books, you can contribute something to the journals. But anyway, you have to find out yourself in which area you have got interest, try to enrich it. Then comes the physical health. Then by enriching that activity, by enriching yourself, the particular thing, you can make yourself very happy. That is very, very important. Then comes the importance of keeping physical health. Physical health is very, very important. As we have got a lot of time, make use of it to enrich ourselves in all possible way, in all possible dimensions. Physical, mental, social, emotional, intellectual, and so on. Physical time, physical dimension comes first. First and the foremost, we all should have good health. For that, it is necessary to do physical exercise and yoga. We may be the teachers. We are the teachers, but even then, physical health is very, very important. It is necessary for that. In order to keep a good physical health, we have to do physical exercises and yoga. There are many apps in the mobile. Download any one which is most suitable for you and practice it every day, at least 1 hour. We can spend for that, either in the morning or in the evening. And in TV channels also, there are many special programs for physical exercise that you can do. That you have to develop it as a practice. Now you practice when you are at home, leisurely sitting and doing some work, you can practice it. Walking, cycling, dancing are very, very good exercise. Walking, we cannot go out at present. So in the terrace, you can have a walk at least for 40 minutes. Cycling, you can do. Cycling also, we cannot go out. On the spot cycling, you can have. Or exercise cycles are there. Half an hour, we can do. Play music or song. And dance for half an hour. I myself have downloaded CureFit app in my mobile. Daily, I have 1 hour I spend over that. I'm doing exercise. It keeps me healthy, hale and healthy. Throughout the day, if I do some physical exercise in the morning, throughout the day, I can find myself quite active. That is very, very important. Another way to keep ourselves hale and healthy is to have healthy food at home with green leaves, vegetables, pulses, and nuts. Yes. Next, I want to give importance to mental health. Yes, usually we may be running here and there. We have to rush. We have to rush up everything in the morning itself. Everything we have to finish in the household work. And then after that only we have to go to college or school, whatever it may be. But nowadays we have got some time. And so we can try to establish good rapport with all the members at home, elders or children. Because in previously, we may not find enough time for that. But now we have got a lot of time. And so we can make the elders at home or the children at home that you are for them. You can play with them. You can use some of the loving words with them. Make them feel that you are for them. You are always with them. Like that, we can make them happy. We can make ourselves happy. And we can make the other people also at home happy. Yes. These are the two major things I want to see. Then apart from all, these two things are very, very important for all the human beings. Apart from all this, there are some skills which we have to enrich and make ourselves empowered. Now, let us see one after another. The first skill as a teacher, as an individual, as the professional, we have to develop is lifelong learning. We have already got many different things. We have learnt a lot, but even then, it is not at all enough. Innovation in teaching and learning is the theme of the webinar. And so for that, we have to think of something new. And so here, the first skill I want to put before is lifelong learning. As we are living in the world of science and development, science and technology, always it is developing. Science and technological field are developing. Because of that, knowledge is developing. I'm not saying developing, explosion, exploding, explode. That meaning we could understand very quick. That is, lot of information is entering into the world. There is an explosion of knowledge. Changes are happening everywhere. And so we have to change ourselves. We have to improve ourselves. We have to enrich ourselves. With what? With new knowledge, with new information, new concept, and so on. We have to develop. We have to keep on learning. Because each dawn brings something new. And it brings some changes into already existing thing. New things is entering into each day. Some new things are coming in. That is why each day we should learn. We have to refer the books. We have to take newspaper. We have to read magazine. We have to listen to the news in the TV or mobile also. There are many apps. Whatever the modem, whatever the device you are using, we all have to learn something new. Maybe we may be working in a company, working in a college, or working in a school. Whatever it may be, we have to develop ourselves. Our main duty is to add something new. These are special duty of the teacher, lecturer, professor, I'm saying, because we are regarded as a highly academic person. And so our great duty is to add something new to the already existing knowledge in our field. We have to change the old and outdated ones into a new one. Otherwise, we have to modify the already existing one. There is certain kinds of knowledge is in existence that we can change it. We can modify into a new one. Anyway, we have to keep ourselves alive. Then only we can continue our work. Then only we will be treated as a professor or lecturer. Otherwise, we will be thrown out of the field. And so the first skill is lifelong learning. Yes, I have to keep it in mind that I have to go on learning. I have to enrich myself day by day. Next skill is acquiring powerful knowledge. Yes, I have already put it in mind that I have to go on learning. I have to go on adding something. But anyway, the second skill I want to give is powerful knowledge. Why is it knowledge is necessary? Because of the knowledge we have already got. Because of the skill we have got mastery. We are able to enjoy the life. I have got a position of assistant professor in my college because of the degree, because of the knowledge, because of the skill I have got mastery. And so I'm able to enjoy the life. I have got a profession. I have got status wherever I go. If somebody asks, yes, I am Dr. Selvi. I'm working as assistant professor in a college. And so I'm able to enjoy a position, enjoy a status with the help of the knowledge I have got. And so updating is a must. All this, how I can develop my knowledge, how can I update myself? There are many different ways. I can read book, I can read article, I can browse through nets, I can converse with the expert. Yes, some of the people, very many great people I may get a chance of meeting. When I meet them, I can talk, I can converse with them, I can get some points. And also, I can attend seminar, I can attend symposium, I can attend workshop or conference. Yes, last year I have gone to Malaysia. I have got a good experience of taking part in the international seminar and also workshop also attended in Penang. That also I have got. By that I have enriched myself. My experience has developed a lot. So we have to develop all these means. Yes, nowadays many webinars are being conducted by very many different institutions. All the things, what are the things you are able to, you are get a chance of attending, you attend and try to update yourself. Because of the update knowledge, we are able to get respect or reverence from the other people. Yes. Next skill is skill of powerful expression. Yes, I have put it in mind that I have to keep on learning throughout my life. Yes. And I developed my knowledge. I have got already, my mind has got become a storehouse of knowledge. If I haven't got expressing power, expressing skill, then what is the use of getting a knowledge? What is the use of having a lot of knowledge? That is why we have to develop the powerful expressing skill also. It is also a must. We should be able to express efficiently and also effectively. There is a slight difference between efficient and effective. What do we mean by efficient? Efficient, I have got much knowledge and so I am efficient in delivering the thing. Effective, that efficient knowledge, with the knowledge I'm able to give something to other person, and so that my points, my idea, my information has to reach the other person. It has to make some impact on other person. It has to make some influence on the other person who are listening to me. And so here comes the effectiveness of my conversation. Our ideas, thinking, feeling to the other person, I should be able to convey in a beautiful manner. When we come to the expressing skill, there are three different sub-skills are necessary. What are they? When Sujata madam asked me, can you give a talk over this topic? Then what is the first step I have done is, I have gathered many different, yes, what are the things I can give? Then I talked with Dr. Venkatraman. He told I'm going to give about the teacher. What are the traits of the teacher I'm going to give? Then immediately I have taken the point. Yes, we can talk of skills. Yes, what are the skills are very, very necessary for the teachers, for the individual, for the student? Yes, I collected many different ideas. Then what is the second step? I organize all the ideas into a good form. Yes, first I have to give one. Second I have to give. Like that I have organized all the ideas into order. Next thing is expressing them in a beautiful manner. Now I get a chance of expressing all the ideas to yourself. So I arranged all the things, I collected all my ideas, arranged in a good order. Then now I'm putting everything, expressing everything in a first, second, third, like that I'm expressing in a beautiful manner. Yes, powerful expression also, one of the skill developed, should be developed by all the teachers. Next skills I want to give is communication. What is communication? Now we all are thinking, by communication, we all are good at communication. Because we think, if I have a talk with other person, if I'm able to give anything to, if I'm able to explain anything to other person, then I'm good at communication. No, communication means we should be able to convey something, and also we should be able to get something from other people. If any person is talking with them, we should be able to grasp the thing. We should have patience enough to listen to them. We should be able to understand the ideas they are giving and act accordingly. Then only I can say, or we can say, that I am good at communication. Communication is very, very important. Communication should be very impressive. When we are listening to some other person, oh, he may be finishing soon. No, don't. He should not finish it. We want to listen. We want to listen to him further. To that extent, we may be impressed because of his communication. Sometimes when the person will finish it off, like that we may have a thinking. So our communication should be very impressive. In communication, there are four different skills: passive skill and active skill. We are good at active skill. We may not have, or we may might not have got mastery of the passive skill. Both the passive and active skill, we should have got mastery. Yes. Here I want to say, who are the best, who is the best communicator? The person who is able to listen to others and try to prolong the communication accordingly is the best communicator. Here I want to give some example. Thirukkural, Thiruvalluvar is a good communicator. Within two lines, he has given a lot. And so in brief manner, he was able to give everything. If we take one kural, though it consists of 1 3/4 lines, then we are able to get something. Great ideas has been given by him. Yes, okay. Then, Hanuman, Kandai Sidhaya he has given. He hasn't given Sidhaya Kandai because what is the purpose of the communication that he has given first? That also. Vadivel, he is a good actor. Then, why we are enjoying his scenes very much? Because he is a good communicator, not only through words, but through gesture also. Through his dress also, he is communicating very many different things. Sometimes, through silence also we can communicate something. For that Manmohan Singh, he is able to communicate through his silence. And one more, in sports field, Dhoni. He is in the field, cricket field, he is not using words. Through his eyes, he is able to convey something to the player. And so if we go to the past, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, he was able to bound the nation together through his powerful, effective communication. Yes. When we categorize the different modes of communication, there are three. Number one is verbal. Number two is non-verbal. Number three is material. I'm able to communicate through my words. Number one, verbal communication. Number two is non-verbal, by gesture. I'm using my hands, eyes, my face, and the upper part. Gesture means upper movement of the upper parts of the body. Through that also, I'm able to convey something. Sometimes, the dress I wear, the purse I have got, the things I may have in my hand also convey something to you. From there, when we see a person on the ground or in the stage, we are able to judge the person by looking, by have a gentle look. We try to get something about them. And so there are three ways. And so all the lecturer, all the teacher, all the professor should be very careful about the words we are using. That is the verbal communication and non-verbal also. Face, just by having a certain look, we can encourage the student, we can give a reinforcement, or we can discourage the student. So we should be very careful in non-verbal communication also. And also, the things we are using also, we should be very careful because we are closely watched by all our students. So when we communicate, we have to have the purpose in my mind, stick to the point, remember that our body tells a lot than our words. Yes, I may say I like you, but I like you, if I say, meaning is not conveyed properly. I like you. I thank you very much. Like that, I have to say. Take care of your tone also. Tone is also very important. First of all, when we get mastery of the communication, the skill, I have to learn the skill of listening. Listen to others for understanding. Then only you have to give. The listening skill, we have to get practice in developing the communication. But whenever we communicate, we have to be very simple because simplicity is the best rule. If you are very simple, the other people may be interested in listening to you. And so clarity is also very important. Simplicity is also very important. Yes. Communication is very, very important. Even if we have got a lot of knowledge, if we lack communication, we cannot give anything. And also our communication should be very effective, very impressive. Then only we can get the minds of the other people. Yes. Next is technological skill. We are living in the world of science and technology. There are many gifts of technology. Computer are there, internet, mobile, tablet, smartphones, smart boards, and etc. Many different things are entering into the field. All these things have already entered into the field of education also. Previously, we used chalk and talk only. In the class, we use the chalk and write something on the board, and we explain with the help of words. That's enough. But nowadays, what happened? We should be able to make use of the online platform. There are many different things. Google is there. GoToMeeting is there. Zoom is there. Cisco meeting is there. In the morning, we had a good meeting. We had a meeting with the director and Abhruva madam and very many people, very many great people. We are able to have in one media, one platform. We got many ideas how we have to undertake that admission and everything. So like that, here also, instead of having a seminar, we are having a webinar through online platform. We are doing something. So knowledge about them. There are many gifts, and knowledge about them, about the gifts of technological development, we have to have. And also, we should have, it is not enough if we have the knowledge about them. We have to have the knowledge of them. I know Sujata madam. I know about Sujata madam. I know of Venkatraman sir. What is the difference between about and of? About them, avangala patti enakku theriyum. Of them, I know fully well about Venkatraman. Yes, there is a difference. So it is not enough if I know something about the technological development. I have to know of them, and also we should be able to make use of all the technological aids, all the technological gadgets for my professional development. If we are the teacher, we have to make the students also use the technology in the class. In the class and for the class, they have to make use. For the class meaning, they have to. If we have to give chance for them to make use of the technological advancement. So when we give an assignment, seminar or project, they are making use of it in the class. When they are at home, they have to prepare. They browse and get many different points with that for the class. That is for the class. Then in the class, when they are assembled in the class or through on online platform, they have to make use of. In the morning, my student, be a student, has explained something regarding preposition. She narrated very well. She taught very well. All the students felt very happy. That is the chance we are giving for the student to make use of the technology, to make use of the advancement of the technology for their development. And so whenever there is a chance for us to give assignment for the student, we have to give assignment or seminar, project, and also we have to engage them. Yes, this is a topic. You have to browse through the net and bring the material to the class. We have to present it in the more online mode. Like that, we have to make them. Whenever possible, we have to encourage them. Yes, I have got mastery of all these things. You too. Because in future, if we have the knowledge of technology only, we can make ourselves, eligible in our field. Otherwise, we couldn't. Like that, we have to make them. Get encouragement from us, inspiration from us. Yes. Next skill is psychological skill. As I have got knowledge, I have good communication skill, technology also, I have got much knowledge. But if I lack psychological skill, what do you mean by psychology? Psychology is study of person. We are not living alone. As a human being, living in group, even in house, we are living together. 4 or 5 or 6 members are living together. There also, we have to have a harmonious life. In school, on college, there are many different people. With all, we have to have a harmonious life, very good life, very understanding life we should have. That is why we should be able to understand the students, colleagues, superior people, and also subordinate people, office people, the management, and a higher official. To understand all these people, we should have the skill and knowledge of psychology. Psychological skill we have to develop. Then only we can understand to whom I am talking. Who are all listening to me? Who are all taking it as a useful thing? Who are all thinking it is when I am teaching the class? I should have the knowledge about that. Yes. How many people are attending my class? 50 students are attending my class. How many people are listening to me? Who are all taking it as a useful one? Who are all taking it as a mere waste? And also, you know, to know the importance of the concept we are teaching. I'm teaching something for the student, whether it is important or not. And also, I may be using some material in the class, whether the material I'm using for the students are appropriate, or the technique I'm using for the using in the class are appropriate or not. But to understand all such things, psychological skill is very, very must. Then only we can have our teaching in a successful manner in the class, and also we can have a good relationship with all the person concerned in the college or the school, whatever it may be. And developing aspiration for action. Yes, we have already got many degrees, much knowledge, much experience. But even at present, we should have high aspiration. Here I want to quote the one Thirukkural, Ulluvathellam uyar ulla mattathu thallinum thallame neethu. We have to have the high aspiration. Vellathanaiyathu malameetam aandharathu ullathan. Like that, in order to progress well, furthermore, upliftment, we should have high aspiration. Matthew Arnold somewhere he told, have one aim, that too high aim. Yes, we should have high aim in our field. I have to finish this one. I have to perform this one. I have to go forward. I have to grow and develop further more and more. Then only we can develop ourselves. We can make all the individuals around us develop. For this, we all should have our own aspiration in our field. Always we have to feel that I'm quite young. I'm going to get retirement within 2 years. Even then I feel I'm quite young. I'm young. I'm full of energy. I'm full of enthusiasm. Then only I can get aspiration. I can develop something. I can put some points, some goals before me. Then only I can find energy and make myself running. Yes, dear participant, you all have to feel young always, and you have got some energy, much energy to perform any action. If you think that it is possible, then all the things are very, very possible for you. And whatever you do enthusiastically, then success is yours. It's creativity. Yes, creativity, innovation. We might have got much experience of meeting many different people, many teachers we might have come across. And so many methodology, many techniques we have known. And also through book also we have learned theory part. What are the different methods of teaching English? What are the different methods of teaching science? What are the different methods of teaching mathematics? There are many different things, many seminars, many webinars we attended. But all the things we have to put it in our mind. But there is no need to make use of any one particular thing. Not necessary. You have to think creatively. Yes, these are the different things. These are the different knowledge. These are the different skills I have got mastered, which is very best, which is very suitable for me. That you have to select. Yes, you have to form something new. You find out something new and better than everything. You put all the things before you. You analyze all the things and synthesize everything. Bring out something new. You have to, your method, your technique, your strategy should be something different, something innovative, something creativity. Then only you can get success. Because all the people tried a lot. And here, the one formula you have to follow is you have to find one new thing for you, and also you have to decide, you have to trial basis, you have to find out whether it is suitable for your class, for your students, for the subject. That all the things you have to analyze, then adopt a new one. If you get success in the first time, in the second time, is it necessary to follow the same methodology, same strategy in the second time? No need. You can improve something. You can develop it still more. And that is, you can make yours further. Next skill, this is very, very important, group dynamic skill. I have gotten experience of serving as a principal in a private college and also in the government institution. I worked as a principal for 3 years. Here, I could get the experience of knowing the importance of good group dynamic skill. There may be some individual, some lecturer, some professor may come. Ma'am, if you want me to do anything, you give the work to me. You allot the work, portion of the work you give to me, I will do. Within 3 days, within 1 week, I will finish. I will submit it to you. But this is not so. Practically, 2 + 2 = 4. But according to group dynamic skill, 2 + 2 = 4. It is more than 4. I have got one kind of work. If I divide the work among 5 people, 20% A, 20% B, like that, if I give, they will finish it up within a week or 10 days or 15 days. They submit everything. The result will be 100%. Instead, if I give the very same work to the group of 5% and make them work in group, the result is not 100%, 150 or 200% work they can do. That is the group dynamics to us, explaining to us. When many minds put together can create wonders. That is what we are able to have a good academic experience, academic feeling I have enjoyed in IAS Saidapet. Because all the people always working together. I enjoyed my days with Dr. Venkatraman and Magishan Madam and many different Vasanti, Dr. Vasanti, Dr. Sagai Mary. We did a lot there in IAS Saidapet. So definitely, when all the minds, when we all sit together, do the work together, we can do great wonders in our college. Further, what is necessary? Group dynamic skills in order to develop skill of adjustment, skill of flexibility, cooperation. Yes, like that, there are many different skills with which we all individual can bind ourselves together. These skills is very, very must. That we have to develop, then only we can do a lot, we can develop, and we can make our organization, make our institution develop a lot. It's very, very important. Next is rapport. Developing rapport. Establishing good rapport with all the people with whom we are working. Management may be there. Colleagues may be there, students are there, and also public also, they are coming and meeting us. For all this thing, with all these people, we should have a smooth relationship, good relationship. How is it possible? Just by developing interpersonal skill. If I have to give a lot about interpersonal skill, it may take 1 hour. And so there are the skills or the qualities with which we can have a good relationship with other people. Or coming under interpersonal skill. All the skills should be developed by all the teachers. Then only they can enjoy the life. They can have a good teaching in the class, good relationship with all the teachers with whom they are working, and also with all the superior under whom they are working, and also with all the office staff also. Next is developing positive thinking and attitude. Yes, it is also necessary. Sometimes we may be doing some work. They have given the work, they have assigned the work to me, and so what is there? I should do, and so I have to do, no other way. Like that, if I have the feeling, then I could not do well. I should have the positive attitude towards it. Yes, this has been assigned to me. This has been given to me. I have been selected by the principal. I have been selected by the HOD. I have been selected by the director. And this work has been given to me, having some trust on me, trust on my experience, trust on my experience, skill, and knowledge. That is why I have to do in a positive mood, in a positive attitude, positive thinking. I do the thing, I do the work. Really, I will get success in my work. That is why பாசிட்டிவ் ஆட்டிடியூட் டுவர்ட்ஸ் அவர் ப்ரொஃபஷன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல், டுவர்ட்ஸ் த மேனேஜ்மெண்ட், டுவர்ட்ஸ் த ஒர்க்கிங் என்விரான்மெண்ட், டுவர்ட்ஸ் த ஸ்டூடெண்ட், டுவர்ட்ஸ் த சப்ஜெக்ட் இஸ் மஸ்ட் ஃபார் அஸ் டு டெவலப். ஆல்வேஸ் வி ஷுட் ஹாவ் பாசிட்டிவ் திங்கிங், we should develop positive thinking. It is very 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 important in order to boost our actions and our behavior. Always we have to think for the best, hope for the best. If you are thinking best, then anyway to some degree we may get success, we may reach that. We can reach that great height if we perform anything with positive thinking and positive attitude. Surely, definitely, they will get success. And so positive result will be the result, will be the end product. Yes. Next skill is developing love and affection. We are the teachers. We are the individual. We are working with individual. And so we have to love ourselves, love our students, love our profession, love the activity we are doing, love all the program, all the program of the college or the school, or in general I can say the atmosphere. And so if we love everything, everything will go on smoothly, peacefully, in a pleasant manner. And so you may think, you may say that I love my friend, I love my colleague. But if you say within you, if you keep your love within you, I am full of love for my student, I am full of love for my son, my husband, for my friend, it is of no use. You got to show the love also to the people also. We are teaching mechanically, we are preparing ourselves, we are presenting all the matters, all the knowledge in the class. And now and then we have to show the love through our words. My dear students, you are listening well, you have written very well, your presentation is very good, I love you all. You are attending my class, you are presenting, like that we have to show our love through words, by using some of the loving words we have to use. And also through action also, we can pat on the back of the student, we can smile at them, we can nod our head positively, like that. We can show our love to all the people. It's also very, very necessary. Yes, now I'm coming to the most probably the last, I think, skill of maintaining mental health. It is very, very important. I have the knowledge, I have the skill, I am properly planning everything, I'm giving everything in a beautiful manner, everybody is loving myself. But when we take the case of mental health, yes, tomorrow we are going to have a emotional intelligence by Radhika Madam. That's also very one of the important topic, important skill all the teacher has to develop. Yes, maintaining mental health. I have knowledge, everything I have got. What are the things are necessary on the part of the teacher? I have, but I am very poor in keeping myself mentally balanced. Then there is of no use. Mental health is nothing but state of mind. Mind is not good. I am not able to have a proper mind, balanced mind. Something might have taken place. Something might have happened in my house. Or on my way to college, way to my school, something happened. All the things I have put it in my mind. Or in the staff room, something might have taken, happened. And so with that, if I entered the class, I couldn't teach well. I may get angry with the students. I may not be able to deliver everything in a good manner. And so it is very, very important. The teacher, all the teaching faculty should keep should take some effort in order to have a good balanced mental health. Then only, if we have the good mental health, then only we can help our students develop or maintain good mental health. If we behave properly, then our students will also behave properly. It is very, very must. You may be lacking in knowledge, you may be lacking in skills, certain skills, but you should be good in your mental health. Then only you can deal with the students, because students are all living individual. In order to handle them, in order to move with them, we have to keep a good mental health. As a piece of conclusion, I want to give something. We all should love all the people, And also, we have to enrich yourself, enrich ourselves. What are the different ways by which I can enrich? We have to find many different ways and go on keeping ourselves, keeping yourself, enriching, number two. And we should be talented enough to, we should be skilled enough to work cooperatively, because nothing we can do alone. We have to live with all the people. Many people are involving. Wherever you go, whatever the work you have to do, you cannot do individually. And so you try to develop the skill of cooperative work. Yes, do service. Yes, we have entered into the very highly, what I can say, profession, noble profession we enter into. That is why it is not enough if we work for the money, work for the salary. We should be ready to do service always. Whenever any student, when any individual approach you for any kind of help, ready, you should be ready to do the service for the individual. The individual may be a layman, or the uneducated person, or the students, or the parents of the students, or the colleague. If they approach, you should be ready to do the service for them in a high contact manner. Service minded, you have to do some work, and we have to keep ourselves happy always. There may be, because we are also individual, we may be many different thinking may be going on. Even then, always we have to try to keep ourselves happy. Yes, although if we worry for any other thing, nothing will happen. And so all the things put aside, when you mingle with other person, when you move with other person, when you talk with other person, try to make yourself happy. Just by smile you show that I am happy and I am also knowledgeable. If by that I can make yourself happy, because it is contagious. If you are happy, then the people who are coming to me can get the contagion, can get the happiness from myself. And so knowledge also they can get from us. So by that, by being happy and being knowledgeable, we can make all the people happy and knowledgeable. Anyway, we all have planned together and work together. Surely we all will grow together. Yes, really, I want to thank that management of Bharathi Women's College, especially that principal. I want to thank for giving a good opportunity for me by conducting a webinar today. And also I want to thank the HOD, Shyamala Madam, HOD of Geography Department, and that organizer, the convener, the Sujata Madam, and also the Grace Madam. I really want to thank you all for having given a good opportunity to extend or to share my views about skills which are very, very necessary on the part of the teacher. Thank you once again. And also, my dear participants, I want to thank you all for your patient listening. Some of the points may be very, very, you may find it important for us to develop. We all have all the qualities, but we may be lacking something. If we find something is lacking within us, we all try to develop something more. Thank you all. Thank you one and all for your patient listening. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Today's topic, Traits of Empowerment of Self, was too apt for you to empower us all. Yes, you did. Make us feel empowered, and we're all the ones who can build and mold young minds. For it, your gripping wisdom, for your knowledge and your years of experience were at ease to break a shell. Once again, I thank you on behalf of each and everyone present here. Thank you, ma'am. Over to Sujata, ma'am, for further sessions. Ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Dear participants, if any clarification or doubt or you can raise your hand, you can clarify your doubts also if you need it. Anybody want to have a suggestion in if yes.
I want to talk. Excuse me, yes. Madam.
Yes, sir, you can raise a question. Venkatramal sir, please.
So first of all, madam is there for the past over 10 years, I am observing the madam, dynamic lady. The thing is, she has done justice for her topic.
Thank you, sir.
What about the traits that has to be, traits or skills that has to be included in the concept, empowerment, she has discussed everything. For that, I'm very happy for that. She has done that. She has fathomed all the issues related with the empowerment. So what is actually empowerment? When we have the content, when we have the commitment, generally we are empowering ourselves. We have to do a responsibility, taking responsibility. Just emphasize that every people has to take their own responsibility for the development, for the cause, the education development. Other she has differently elaborated. Then she has elaborated on lifelong learning skills. So education needs to be learned, education educated. Each and every gateways of the knowledge use the more information. Then this example for needy in the room of Kelly and the middle of the room may know.
Excuse me, sir. The voice is not at all clear. You can set the mic like that.
Need in the Madi Kalvi. அன்பு மிகுதி உடையவர் மேலோ தட் யூ எக்ஸ்பிளைன் தட் கான்செப்ட் யூ எக்ஸ்பிளைன் தென் த டெக்னாலஜி நாலேஜ் டெக்னாலஜி சைக்காலஜி ஐ ஆக்சுவேட்டிங் டெவலப்பிங் பாசிட்டிவ் திங்கிங் யூ கேன் எக்ஸ்பிளைன் நாட் வெரி தட் ஒன் ஹஸ் டு டெவலப் நாட் ஓன்லி ஃபார் த ஃபியூச்சர் யூ கேன் எவ்ரி இண்டிவிஜுவல் சிட்டிசன் ஆஃப் இந்தியா ஹேவ் டு டெவலப் Just like the peace has to develop in the mind, heart and minds of the students, just like that, the empowerment, the concept of empowerment has to develop in the heart and minds of the students, that is taking responsibility. And then last you explained, Udayadu Vilambel, what Abhaya has said, don't take, be a positive attitude. What are the problems you are having in your mind? Don't expose to others. So that is what Avayara said, Udayadu Vilambi. So finally, she has done the justice, a comprehensive, elaborate, in-depth talk on that. I congratulate madam, the women in the world, Nalla Panunga, and the North I am boosting. In the previous college, you are the only person who can develop more information, more dynamic in exposing the knowledge and information, everything in the following year. You are the same thing. You have done the justice for this program. Thanks a lot, madam. Thanks very much.
I think participant sides are, everyone is satisfied. We can go for the vote of thanks of the day. I deem it is a great honor and privilege to propose the vote of thanks today on this occasion. Let me first of all start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's occasion a resounding success. The best and beautiful things in the world cannot be seen or even touch. They must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such prayer among them. My words are not enough to express my gratitude on behalf of the college. And now I would like to thank our special guest speaker, Dr. Mrs. Shelvi S. Madam, who despite her busy schedule, found time to grace this occasion. I would like to thank our honorable principal, Dr. D. Gladys, Bharathi Women's College, to given me this very good opportunity to conduct this event. And I thanks our head of the department, Dr. R. Shamla, and our staff members of our department, friends, for their kind cooperation. I thank all the distinguished invitees and our college staff members who are present here, accepted our invitation. I think my speech won't be completed if I did not thank all the participants in this wonderful occasion for their kind cooperation. Thank you, one and all present here. Thank you once again. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
போட்டீங்களா? நம்ம பிள்ளைங்க வர மாட்டாங்க பாருங்க. இன்னைக்கு வந்திருக்காங்க 4 பேரும் 5 பேரும் வந்திருக்காங்க. பிரேமா, அப்புறம் விமலா வந்திருந்தாங்க 2. 3 வந்து கிருஷ்ணமூர்த்தி வந்திருந்தான். அப்படியே கொஞ்ச பேர் வந்திருந்தாங்க. பரவாயில்ல.
செல்வி மேம்,
ஹலோ.
செல்வி மேம், தாறு மாறு தக்காளி சோறு சொல்றாங்கல்ல அத மாதிரிதான் சூப்பரா இருந்தது உங்களுக்காகவே நான்
வந்தேன் வந்துட்டேன் சந்தோஷம் உங்க சுஜாதா மேடம் தான் கேட்டாங்க நிறைய பண்ண கூட சுஜாதா மேடம் இப்ப நம்ம கவர்மெண்ட் காலேஜ்ல யாரு இன்னொரு சார் இருக்கிறாரு யாரு பேர்
குட் ஆஃப்டர்நூன் பலராமன்
பலராமன் சார் எனக்கு சந்தோஷம் சார் உங்களை பார்த்தோன்னா ஃபீல் தெரியுது
very nice madam very nice sorry ma'am
sir sir sir
very nice ma'am very nice
sir நல்லா இருக்கீங்க சார்
very nice sir very nice sir how are you sir
madam meena madam எப்படி இருக்கீங்க
நல்லா இருக்கேன் சார் நல்லா இருக்கேன்
இப்ப என்ன வேலை பாக்குறீங்க
பாரதி விமன்ஸ்ல தான் வேலை பாக்குறேன்
பாரதி விமன்ஸ்லயா
ம் அதுதான் எங்களுக்கு
பலராமன் சார்
சார் நான் சேலையூர் தாம்பரம் சேலையூர்
நீங்க எங்க எந்த ஸ்கூல்ல ஒர்க் பண்றீங்க
தாம்பரம் சேலையூர் ஹையர் செகண்டரி ஸ்கூல்
எங்க இருக்குது அது
இங்க தாம்பரம் சார் நியர்பை தாம்பரம்
மிலிட்டரி ரோடு பக்கத்துல
ஆமாங்க சார்
சரி சார் ரைட் சார் தேங்க்யூ சார் வாங்க சார்
வாழ்த்துக்கு வாங்க வாங்க
வர வர தேங்க்யூ மேடம் நல்லா இருக்கீங்களா
நல்லா இருக்கேன்
சார் நல்லா இருக்கேன்
சரி சரி சார் ரைட் தேங்க்யூ
சரி சார் தேங்க்யூ
சார் மேடம் விக்ரம் எப்படி இருக்காரு விக்ரம் எப்படி இருக்காரு
நல்லா இருக்கறான் பெங்களூர்ல வர்க் பண்ணிட்டு இருக்காரு
சரி சரி தேங்க்யூ மேம் உங்களை பார்த்து ரொம்ப சந்தோஷம் அப்புறம் பேசுவோம் ரொம்ப நன்றி மேம் ரொம்ப நன்றி மேம்
ஹலோ
கேக்குதுங்களா மேம்
ஒரு நிமிஷம் கொஞ்சம் எனக்கு ரொம்ப டீப்பாவும் போவும் எனக்கு பயம் என்னன்னா நீங்க நல்லா சொன்னீங்க ஆனா எனக்கு வந்து உங்களோடது பிடிக்கும். நம்ம வந்து உண்மையிலேயே என்ஜாய்டு பீயிங் தேர். சைதாப்பேட்டில இருந்தத ரொம்ப நான் என்ஜாய் பண்ணேன். சரி சரி சொல்ல மாட்டாங்க சார், எனக்கு தெரியும் சார். ஆமா எனக்கு தெரியும். ஆமா ஆமா சொல்ல மாட்டாங்க, எனக்கு தெரியும். For your compliment. நல்லாவும் சொன்னீங்க. ஆமா சார், ஆமா சார். சார் இது வந்து எனக்கு ஒரு சந்தோஷம் சார். அல்வா சாப்பிட்ற மாதிரி நீங்க பிரைஸ் வர்த்தி வேர்ட் சொல்றீங்க. இட்ஸ் வெரி ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல் ஃபார் மீ. இட் இஸ் ஆக்டிங் as a டானிக் ஃபார் மீ.
ஆமா சார், நல்லா இருக்கீங்களா சார்? சார்
சார் ரொம்ப நல்லா இருக்கு.
ஆ நான் நீங்க அப்பா அடிக்கடி போன்ல பேசிட்டு போய் நான் கேட்டுட்டே இருப்பேன். அடிக்கடி பேசி ஆமா 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 நல்லா இருக்கீங்களா சார்? நல்லா இருக்கீங்களா சார்? போறீங்களா? வீட்ல இருக்கீங்களா? கொஞ்சம் பார்த்து பார்த்து போங்க சார். வெளியில போறப்ப கொஞ்சம் தூரமா இருந்தே பழைய இங்க கூட்டமா இருந்து அந்த இடத்துல போக வேண்டாம். மெட்ராஸ் ரொம்ப டேஞ்சரஸ். அவன் கணக்கு கொடுக்கறதெல்லாம் பொய் கணக்கு தான், வெளியில கொடுக்கறதெல்லாம். அதனால நம்ம தான் பார்த்து இருந்துக்கணும் சார். நம்ம சரி சரி சார். ஸ்பீச் எப்படி மேடம் ஸ்பீச்? உங்களுக்கு தான் நீங்க அடிக்கடி கேட்டிருப்பீங்களா? நீங்க உங்களுக்கு அதை பத்தி தெரியுமா? உங்களுக்கு கபிலா மேடம் டோன் சூப்பரா இருக்கு சார். ஸ்பீச் சூப்பரா இருக்கும். டோன் சவுண்ட் நல்ல இல்ல. நான் ஒரு ஒரு மீட்டிங் அந்த இது ஐஏசி ப்ரோக்ராம் ஒன்று அட்டன் பண்ணேன் சார். நல்லா பண்ணாங்க. ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ்க்கு எப்படி மோட்டிவேட் பண்றது, ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் எப்படி பண்றது வைக்கிறதுல நல்லா அழகா நல்லா இருக்கு சார். டோன் அப்படியே கணீர் கணீர் இருக்கு சார். ஸ்பீச் நல்லா இருக்கு கேட்கறதுக்கு. சரிங்க சார். இல்ல ஸ்வீட்டா இருக்கும் சார், கேக்குறதுக்கு நல்ல. நான்